Hi, I'm Joshua Stern, and thanks again for watching our video blog. Today, I wanted to talk about 10 helpful tips for selling a condo. So, first, learn about the process of selling a condo. One of the biggest mistakes made when selling a condo is believing it's the same process of selling a single family home. The first tip for selling a condo is to educate yourself on the process so you understand what to expect throughout the process. One of the easiest ways you can educate yourself on the process is to discover helpful resources like this one on condominium selling. Sellers who understand things such as how long does it take to sell a condo, how much does it cost to sell a condo, how to prepare and sell a condo on a budget, improve the chances of a smooth condo sale, all right? Number two, know condo associations, rules, regulations, fees, assessments. One of the major differences between selling a condo and selling a single family home are the homeowners associations, rules, regulations, fees, and potential assessments, if not ongoing assessments. When selling a single family home, it's unlikely that an HOA is involved, which typically makes the process easier because fewer parties are involved. Condo owners are obviously aware of the pros and the cons of homeowners associations, but that doesn't necessarily mean potential buyers will be. So it's important when selling a condo that you're fully aware of and disclose all of the rules, the regulations, the fees, the potential special assessments to any buyer. A common real estate contract contingency that's made by condo buyers is the ability to review the HOA rules and regulations. This contingency states that the purchase contract is contingent upon the buyer's and their attorney's review of HOA rules and regulations. Before listing your condo for sale, gathering any HOA documents will save a lot of time. Not having proper documents readily available is one of the reasons real estate closing is delayed. It's a big reason why a real estate closing is going to be delayed. So you must be proactive and gather that information beforehand. Number three, hire a realtor. Who knows better how to sell a condo? One of the common culprits of unsuccessful condo sales is hiring the wrong realtor. So when selling a condo, it's critical that you hire a realtor who knows how to sell a condo. And there are some obvious signs that you've hired the wrong real estate agent to sell your property that you need to be aware of. For example, if you get your agent's voicemail every time you call them, you've hired the wrong agent. Frequent communication with your real estate agent is critical, especially when selling a condo. And there are many tips for interviewing real estate agents when selling a condo, and also some specific questions you should consider asking prospective agents. Below are four of the most common questions to ask while interviewing agents to sell your home. Number one, how many condos do you typically sell in a year on average? Number two, do you have preferred lenders who offer financing on condos for potential buyers? Number three, would any of your past condo sellers be willing to discuss their experience with me? Number four, how do you market condos to prospective buyers who are actually interested in buying a condo? So when selling a condo, selecting an agent who knows what they're doing can be the wild card you need to have a successful sale. An experienced realtor not only knows the process of selling a condo, but they're also going to know how to price a condo and how to market the condo. Number four, decide on the right listing price of your condo. The two most common or most important factors, I should say, in the sale of condominiums are price and marketing. By hiring the right realtor, you'll have one of the two factors covered. The next tip for selling a condo is decide on the right listing price of your condo. There are a lot of mistakes that can be made when pricing real estate that you must be aware of, especially when selling a condo or a townhome. For example, pricing your condo higher to leave room for buyer negotiations. This can be a very big mistake, right? Hiring the realtor will also help you decide on the right listing price for your condo, because an experienced agent is also going to know how to determine the market value or the property value and provide their recommendation for a listing price. And the same agent will also not be afraid to turn down a listing if they feel the seller is being unrealistic with the price that they want to list their condo for. Overpricing a property, let's just say it this way, it's devastating. It's a great way for you not to sell your condo. Well, there's not an exact formula to determine the listing price for a condo. There's some excellent methods and data that can help improve the chances the right listing price is going to be chosen. Number five, Get your condo ready for the market. The first couple of weeks that a condo is for sale should be the busiest for showings. Maybe it's the first couple of days. And there's only one opportunity to make a great first impression on prospective buyers, so it's vital your condo is ready for the market. Correctly preparing a condo for the market does require a little bit of time, a little bit of effort, and potentially some money. Are you gonna have a pre-listing inspection? Are you going to stage your condo? These are just a couple of important questions to consider as you're getting your condo ready for the market. And if you decide to stage your condo, make sure you evaluate it, what it'll be worth. There are some great cheap staging tips to consider, and if you don't wanna spend a lot of money on staging your condo, that's the way to go. The most important takeaway with this tip is just to be sure that when your condo is officially for sale, that it is ready to be viewed by prospective buyers. Because one of the quickest way to turn off a buyer is to have them walk into a property that's a complete mess or a property that clearly needs repairs. Number six, decide whether open houses are worth it. In our world, we think they're worth it, but one decision that must be made by a condo seller is whether or not to allow open houses. There are pros and cons to open houses, and it's important to weigh them before deciding. The realtor that you're going to hire to sell your condo will likely have their own opinions on the open houses. Some agents are all for open houses, and others won't. My personal opinion is open houses are awesome. Pre-marketing a property, staging that property correctly, putting the floodgate down and letting the water build up behind the floodgate, and then opening up the floodgate to the grand opening is like an open house on steroids. All of the buyers are coming into the property at the same time. And by the way, quicker access to more buyers simply means your home's gonna sell for more money in less time. And honestly, I think that's what you're looking for when it comes to selling a condo or a townhome. Number seven, accommodate showing requests. So another important tip for selling a condo is to accommodate all the showing requests if possible. Restricting showings is one of the worst mistakes when selling a property. Selling a condo is certainly not convenient, and showings can be requested at any given moment, hopefully with a little bit of notice. And while it may be inconvenient to leave your condo for an hour on a Sunday morning, it may be the only time the prospective buyer has available to view your condo. Anytime a seller is being difficult with showing requests, it raises the question whether they're actually interested in selling the property. So, sellers who understand that preparing and accommodating for showings can be inconvenient, they're not as stressed, because when the requests are made, it just makes the whole process more enjoyable. Number eight, prepare for inspections. That's right, there are dozens of reasons to have an inspection when buying a home. And it's important to realize that while selling a condo, that it's likely the buyer is gonna have their own inspection done. Another great tip for selling a condo is to prepare for the inspections. So most sellers don't even realize there's some great ways to prepare for the inspections when selling a condo. Tasks such as checking the functionality of your condo's plumbing, windows, lighting, appliances, and just do your best to eliminate potential issues before they become an issue to a buyer. Sellers who understand how to prepare for a home inspection greatly decrease the chances that the transaction is going to fall through because of the inspection. The inspection period is generally fairly short, so make it count, 10 to 14 days. Do your homework. Number nine, you can, and this is optional, in the state of Utah, you can hire an attorney who has experience with condo closings. Perhaps they can assist you with the review of HOA documents, what that might mean to you. They can look at the CC&Rs and understand what that may mean to you. If there are assessments that are levied against the property by the HOA, they can provide advice on that. In Utah, we don't see attorneys involved as often in a real estate transaction, but sometimes if you're a buyer, it's worth having an attorney perhaps look over that paperwork for you. And then number 10, you just have to start packing and preparing for the move. That's right. Since the ultimate goal of selling a condo is to get the property sold, it makes sense to begin packing and preparing for the move. It's somewhat common that sellers will wait until the last minute to begin packing and preparing for their move, which doesn't make a lot of sense to me. So whether your plan is to move to a new city or move to a bordering neighborhood, packaging and preparing for the move is important, and it can greatly reduce stress. One of the most basic tips for preparing a condo for the market is to declutter and make the property look spacious. So putting things in boxes or storage even before listing, it's just a good idea. It just makes sense. In addition to putting belongings into boxes or storage, lining up a moving company in advance is also important, because a lot of moving companies are booked out weeks, especially during the busy season. So waiting until the last minute can create a huge issue if there's no reputable moving companies that are available to help with your move. If you have any questions about selling your condo or townhome, our contact information is below. Thanks again for watching the video blog.
Thank you.